Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So the question is, you have a table named employees and you need to rank all those employees based on the salaries. So in the table employee, you have four columns: employee ID, name, department and salary. And you have to add another column in the output called employee rank, and those values should be either top performer, average performer or least or worst performer. So the logic is, if the employee has to be the top performer, the employee salary should be the highest in his or her department. So if you see for Grace, the department IT, the highest salary is 7500 and Grace is having that salary, so he's the top performer. And for the employee to be average performer, that employee salary should be the difference between his salary and the department's highest salary should be less than 10%. So if the difference is less than 10%, he is average performer. If the difference is greater than 10%, he is worst performer. So hope you all understood the question. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and how to solve this using SQL. So this is the table input, select star from employees, which I discussed in the input earlier. So now what we have to do, as we know the logic, first rank employees based on the highest salary of the department. Highest salary of the department. Okay, so to get this, first what we need to do, for every department we need to calculate the highest salary. So for that there are multiple ways, but let's use a different way. We can always use the max of salary, or you can use a dense rank and to get the maximum salary. So let's see how to do this. So first select department comma max of salary as max s from employees group by department. So in this way we are going to get the maximum salary for each and every department. And now what I'll do, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as, okay, and select from employees E left join CTE C on E dot department is equal to C dot department. And now E dot star comma C dot star. When I do this, let's see what is the input we are getting when we run this query. So what we are getting, for every employee we are getting the maximum salary. So what I'll do, instead of writing the entire columns, I'll take maximum salary. So but we know to rank the employees, we have to find the difference between that employee salary and the maximum salary, right? So here what I'll do, I'll find the difference. So that is max s minus salary into 100.0 divided by salary. So max s means the maximum salary of the department minus salary of the particular employee. We are calculating the difference and dividing it by the salary of that employee, and we are multiplying it 100 into 100.0. we are using 0.0 because we want to get the percentage in a decimal value. So when I run this, we'll get the difference between salary and the maximum salary, the difference percentage difference. So in this way you're getting the percentage difference, right? So now what we need to do, we need to write a case statement to rank the employees. So case when this particular value is equal to 0, then best performer. When this particular percentage is less than or equal to 10.10, then average performer. Else worst performer. Performer, and as employee rank. Okay, so when you run this, this is the output we are getting: worst performer, best performer. So for sales, If you see the highest salary is 6000, so he's the best performer, and the second is 5500. So the difference between these two salaries is less than 10%. So he's the average performer. And for employee one, the salary is 5000, which is the difference between the top salary and his salary is greater than 10%. So it is worst performer. So in this way, we are calculating the average employee rank. Okay. So this is one method. And now the second method is using first value, first underscore value. Okay. So first underscore value, it will give you the first row of that entire data set. So for that, select star comma first underscore value of salary over partition by department order by salary descending as max s from employees. So in this way we will get the highest salary for each department. So for IT the highest salary is 7500, for marketing the highest salary is 7000, and for sales the highest salary is 6000. So there is one more function called last value as well, last underscore value of salary over same way, same thing I'll copy and max SS, and instead of descending I'll just keep the S, I'll not keep anything. So by default it will take the ascending order. So if I do this way also, we'll get the same. Okay, last value is giving us a different different value. So 7500, it is okay. 6500, 7000. Okay, max SS. So last value is not giving us the required output. Okay, so we just need to use the first value function. So once we do the first value function, what we can do again the same way, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as and select from CTE. So employee ID comma name comma department comma max s, sorry, salary minus max s into 100.0 divided by salary. Okay, and here I'll use again the same case statement here. And I'll just copy this. Okay, I think it is max of maxes minus salary. So yeah, this is the same logic which we have to use. And now if I run this, we'll get the same output. So these are the two ways. First is using the simple max operator, max function to get the max of salary, and then you have to apply a join here. But without using the join also, we can get the same value by using the first value function. So hope you like this video and also the two solutions. So if you like this video, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.